growing up, my dad was very mechanically oriented and we were always fixing something. So there seems to be something in the genetic background that keeps pulling us into mechanical repair and engine systems and so forth. I'm Stephen Belkoff, I'm an associate professor of mechanical engineering. And this is a 1947 Ford 8N tractor. It comes from an era where the systems are for the most part all mechanical. So it's a perfect platform for the students because you can see the systems operating. I had them take it apart on their own and then try to figure out how was it supposed to work. I don't think anybody in this class has ever worked on a farm tractor before, so it's all new to them.
This in here, you got to be careful, and although there is a scale here. All right, so if you're looking at this way, looking at this way, you can still read it. So anyway, how does this work? Tell me.
This class is a class in reverse engineering and diagnostics, and it started out through an acknowledgement that the students coming into the institution didn't have the same background as previous generations of students did. Rolling the tractor in here and having the tactile interaction is a much more meaningful experience. Students who are intimidated by mechanical systems can be free to sort of explore, be curious, and delve into it as deep as they want to.
It's nice to be able to apply the theory we learn in our classes to something that is physical and we can touch and see and handle. It gives us a chance to learn on our own, and it actually, I think, has made it easier to learn what we need to do and kind of develop the habits that'll be important in our futures.
And then also, like, it's just fun to play with and fun to, you know, figure out, like, you can really see for yourself and figure things out what is happening with each subsystem, and I think that's really cool.